Google the words background check and you'll get thousands of results. Before you conclude that any of these companies could serve your screening needs, it is important to keep in mind that not all background checks are the same. As a matter of fact, finding out if someone is a criminal is more of an art than a science. The sentiment that all background checks are the same could not be further from the truth. So let's take a moment to dispel some myths. Myth number one, a background check is a background check is a background check. In reality, there are many components to a background check, and these components are contingent on variable factors, including 1. The reason for the check. 2. The type of position an individual is applying for. And 3. Industry-specific requirements. Each of these variables can affect the breadth, scope, and cost of a background check. To further illustrate, if you are hiring someone that will be working with children, you probably want to know if they have ever been convicted as predators or violent offenders. If you are hiring someone that will be handling large amounts of your company's cash, you may want to run a credit report. If you are hiring a delivery driver, you will want to run a motor vehicle report. What a background check contains depends on what employers ask for, and employers have differing needs and request different searches. Examples of different background screening searches include criminal, credit, employment verifications, and reference checks. In addition, drug and health screenings and/or specific industry-specific searches may be required. Now that we have an understanding of the different components that make up a background check, let's move on to myth number two. All background screening reports are compliant. As an HR professional, you know that you must stay compliant with all federal, state, and local employment laws. What you may not know is that according to the FTC, background checks that rely only on databases compiled from stored data in public criminal records are not FCRA compliant and should not be used for hiring purposes. To be compliant, all records must be current as of the date searched and obtained from the original source. It's also important to keep in mind that not all background screening companies provide compliant data that you can use in a hiring scenario. And since hiring laws mostly apply to the end user, and the FCRA, among other laws, have mandates strictly specific for end users and employers. Background screening companies can provide you with any information they want as long as they are following their requirements, and not all even do that, potentially leaving employers to fend for themselves. With more than 3,500 consumer reporting agencies in the United States and less than 1% of them accredited by industry associations and certified for quality controls, employers should vet their screening partners carefully. To illustrate, let's look at Wally and Tom. Wally, who has his MBA and investigator's license, opens a consumer reporting agency and applies for accreditation and quality control certifications to ensure he is providing his customers with compliant background check reports. Tom, on the other hand, plays an investigator on TV and decides he needs to supplement his income, so he also opens a consumer reporting agency. But Tom does not want to be bothered with accreditations or certifications because they are expensive and difficult to maintain or keep. He just wants to spit out database reports and collect his money. While the barriers to entry to becoming a consumer reporting agency are low, the barriers for compliance are high. So, regardless of company size or tenure, it always makes sense to check your consumer reporting agency's credentials to make sure they will support your compliance requirements and keep you out of hot water. Now that you have a better understanding of how not all background screening reports or companies are compliant, let's talk about the misconceptions surrounding one of the most common searches available, the National Criminal Database search. It is important to understand that while these types of searches are effective high-level tools in researching criminal backgrounds, they are not good standalone products and can be misleading. They may appear to be comprehensive national searches, but since not all states and counties make their records available to these types of databases, the information is often inaccurate, outdated, incomplete, or simply missing. Again, to be compliant, any information found through the database search must be confirmed with the original agency where the record was initially filed to remain in compliance with FCRA standards. So now that you know the limitations of straight database searches, let's debunk myth number 3. There is one place you can go to obtain any and all criminal information about an individual. Unfortunately, this is not the case. There is no such thing as an all-inclusive, real-time, 50-state national criminal database where information about all criminal activity, or any other information for that matter, is collected. The world of consumer reporting is nothing like what you see on CSI or blockbuster FBI movies that include characters like Jason Bourne. As much as PeopleTrail would love to have investigators flipping through futuristic floating projections of data containing an individual's cell phone records, medical history, criminal profile, and online surfing habits, one, that consolidated information and technology does not yet exist in the real world, and two, it is illegal to investigate an individual without their consent. In fact, law enforcement can only do so after reasonable suspicion is obtained, and many times it requires a warrant from a judge. With this in mind, let's examine the real process of retrieving criminal records. Because there is no such thing as an all-inclusive real-time national criminal database, the best search option available is to retrieve records by hand from county courthouses where your applicant has resided, and possibly all nearby touch counties. In addition, employers may want to consider conducting federal criminal searches, since these include crimes that cross state lines or crimes committed against federal agencies, which are prosecuted by the FBI, DEA, Secret Service, Federal Marshal, etc. Federal records many times cannot be found in the local county or municipal courts. Although hits are rare, federal crimes tend to be of a more serious nature, while county records are prosecuted by local law enforcement and are the most detailed, accurate, and up-to-date searches available. Currently, there are over 3,200 counties in the United States and over 10,000 courthouses. The federal court system has 94 district courts, 13 circuit courts, and one Supreme Court. And unless you plan on spending an enormous sum of money searching every available jurisdiction, you will probably want to narrow that search down a bit. Since there is no real-time national criminal database, employers must balance cost with risk tolerance to formulate the best background search for their needs. Background checks are important, but they are only as useful as the tools used to obtain the criminal information. Different industries and unique situations will cause the background investigation process to vary from employer to employer. But with every circumstance, there is a right or best method to search for an applicant's criminal history. If you are seeking the added layers of accuracy, timely delivery, compliance direction, and personalized care that only a company focused on the human touch can provide, PeopleTrail is your solution.